Microsoft Defender for Office 365 offers a variety of security-related reports you can use to assess its effectiveness in your org. The Email and Collaboration Reports page presents a card for each report, and each card summarizes the report data to give you a basic understanding of its contents. You can move your pointer across charts to see each data point, and move it into the key to highlight each item in the chart. Of course, you can view a report's details by selecting View Details on its card. The Threat Protection Status Report describes the number of messages containing malicious files or URLs that the Anti-Malware Engine Zero Hour Auto Purge, or ZAP, and Defender for Office 365 features blocked. Use this information to identify trends or determine if you need to adjust the org's policies. By default, this report includes both Exchange Online Protection and Defender for Office 365 blocks over the past week. You can, of course, filter the results to focus your analysis. Date, detection type, protection, tags, and domains are available for filtering. In this example, you can focus on Defender for Office 365, think safe links, safe attachments, and anti-phishing, and priority accounts to gain clarity on its protection of these accounts. The default report is an overview, but other views are available. But the system override view is especially useful. It can help you determine the quantity and reasons for malicious emails delivered to recipients. Common reasons are a safe senders list, an allowed IP address, and so on. The Mail Flow Status Report is also useful when evaluating the effectiveness of Defender for Office 365. It shows data about incoming and outgoing email, including spam and malware detections, as well as good email, including email blocked on the edge before Exchange Online Protection evaluates it. The funnel view identifies which email threat protection features filter incoming and outgoing email in your org. The top of the funnel represents all the email entering the org, and as you progress down the funnel, it shows how each threat protection feature reduced the number of messages delivered. The top portion of the funnel represents email filtered by Exchange Online Protection. The bottom portion is more useful when evaluating the effectiveness of Defender for Office 365. Below the funnel chart, you can see the same data in the table, organized by date. The tech view offers more granular details than the funnel view, as it shows how different stages of threat protection categorize emails. As before, the top line represents all incoming email, and as you move down the chart, you see how much email was allowed by each tech versus how many messages were blocked by the detection type. One question you might have is, how does email detonation affect mail delivery? Numerous factors affect mail delivery times, so an absolute time is not a good indicator. Answer that question by using the Mail Latency Report. It qualifies email delivery based on statistical data about the delivery times of other messages. First, the 50th percentile represents average delivery time for email, while the 90th percentile indicates a high latency for email delivery, with only 10% of messages taking longer to deliver. The 99th percentile is the highest latency for email delivery. The last report I want to show you is the URL Threat Protection Report. It summarizes the number of URL threats detected by SafeLinks and the actions taken on them over time. Reports in Defender for Office 365 help you to monitor and assess its effectiveness. See our documentation on Microsoft Docs for more information about them.